Welcome back. This is the final video of this series on evaluating evidence. I want to summarize what has been covered so far throughout this series and explore some of the key differentiators between science and pseudoscience, and ultimately the difference between thinking scientifically and thinking pseudoscientifically. These differences shouldn't be thought of as binary, but differences at two opposing ends of a continuum. First, thinking scientifically means we resist the temptation of using personal, anecdotal experiences in guiding what claims we accept and reject. Anecdotes aren't controlled, aren't representative, nor use any systematic methodology in general, and thus cannot be used as evidence of anything causal. Instead, we should rely on dispassionate statistical evidence. This is tough because human beings are emotionally compelled by anecdotes and stories, whereas statistical data is often dry and fails to capture our interest. However, quantitative assessments are indispensable if you want your beliefs to align with reality. Second, a scientific worldview focuses on the weight of evidence, whereas pseudoscience thrives on cherry-picking data and focusing on outlier studies to support its conclusions. When you put forth a claim, be honest about whether you've confirmed that the claim conforms to the weight of evidence in peer-reviewed scientific journals. This is the bullseye, since most of us do not possess the expertise necessary to intimately understand the research in most fields. We should be extremely doubtful of ourselves when we reach conclusions that don't conform to this weight of evidence. Of course, respecting the scientific consensus of experts is a shorthand for the weight of evidence, and thus, when we find ourselves out of step with this consensus of experts, extreme caution is warranted. Remember, inflated confidence in our abilities is a common cognitive bias that we, non-experts, often fall victim to. Those pushing pseudoscience will often reject the consensus, either by denying it exists, by denying it's important, or, most insidiously, by claiming that some sort of conspiracy theory exists to subvert the truth from coming forward. Moving on, thinking scientifically means relying on the most robust methods possible, which generate reproducible results, a trademark of legitimate, reliable science. When possible, the most robust scientific results will come from double-blinded, placebo-controlled, randomized controlled trials with adequate sample sizes, make use of robust statistical procedures, and be published in reputable, peer-reviewed journals. Pseudoscientists often rely on studies without blinding, without placebo controls, with flawed statistical methods, are published in unreputable journals, or worse, make claims without published evidence whatsoever. Next, scientific claims are careful, tentative, and don't supersede the available evidence. Pseudoscientific claims are often grandiose, sensationalist, or absolute, far exceeding what can be justified by the available evidence. Likewise, scientific claims are falsifiable. Thus, our beliefs, if they are to be science-based, must also be falsifiable. That is, we must be able to state the conditions, at least in theory, that could change our minds about our belief. Pseudoscientific beliefs are often guided by ideology or identity, not evidence, and thus are not structured in a way that allows for correction. They are often guided by dogma. And this brings us to the final distinction between science and pseudoscience that I'll leave you with. Science is in a continual process of update, and thus thinking scientifically means holding no belief sacred, always being open to belief revision. Pseudoscience is often immune to evidence that criticizes its foundational tenets, and thus rarely changes or updates. This brings me to the end of this project's focus on the skeptical toolset that one needs to navigate and assess scientific claims. From this point on, I'm going to delve into specific subjects and demonstrate how to apply these skeptical tools to specific issues and claims. I'll start with the world of alternative medicine.